Shocking secrets unveiled in covert meeting. Why and R's Tucker and Ashley's reunion plans ruined. Mariah and Tess's major decision shakes Genoa City. Plus, new soap The Gates poised to steal Y&R stars. Who's exiting next? Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope everyone is having a wonderful day. After watching these videos, please hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. Tucker realizes something is strange after seeing Ashley's actions, and, spoiler alert, he sets up a covert meeting with Jordan. On this episode of The Young and the Restless, Nikki loses her cool at AA, Ashley makes a promise to Tucker in front of Audra, and Mariah and Tessa consider moving. When Mariah enters society, she asks Madam Manager if it's time for her to clock out. She wants to sit down and enjoy a bite, but Tessa needs to finish up some business. They eat and sip wine before Tessa gives an explanation. She describes to her how she was stopped by a ranch security who mistook her for Jordan. Being new, he quickly began to apologize after realizing his error. Mariah will take Victor to task for it. Although Tessa is relieved that there is security, she feels that this is becoming excessive and is concerned about how it might impact Aria. Is it time to move, perhaps? Is raising their child at the ranch the correct decision? The Newmans are a nuisance to everyone around them and lead a noisy life. Mariah never imagined that their stay would be permanent. They are not Newmans, even though it is the Newman Ranch. They ought to build their own house soon. They browse at properties online while lounging on the couch. They would have to go to the park if they wanted green space. They discover a country house that fits their budget. They should prepare a list of what they desire because Mariah does not want to migrate to the country. They talk about learning to cook once they stumble onto a place with a kitchen. Tessa enjoys making plans for the future. Together, they have a lifetime. Since none of them had parents who loved them when they were kids, they get to instill it in their daughter. They wouldn't want to share this fantasy with anyone else. Tucker receives an urgent text from Ashley in his apartment at the athletic club asking to meet. He asks her over the phone what this is all about. He doesn't think it's worth talking to her about this over the phone, but she won't. He will shatter a few chairs in her honor before leaving for Paris without her. He really wants she will wish him a good voyage since this is becoming old. She is adamant that after they speak in person, he will reconsider everything. Ashley shows up in his suite, and he wonders whether this has anything to do with Abby's previous visit. He also notes that Ashley's kid is acting strangely after she begged Devin to forgive her. He was given notice by her daughter. Ashley thinks that's kind but superfluous. Tucker claims that both she and her daughter are perplexed. Although she can appreciate his skepticism, she wishes their relationship had continued. She wants to be involved in every single facet of his life because they have never felt the same with anyone else. He has no faith in her. She says it requires sincerity. He tells her to shut up and says it won't happen. Though he is certain that this is a fraud, he believed she could have something truthful to say. She reaches out to him and tells him she has one goal in mind. Refusing to fall into this trap, he retreats. The Abbots believe they can return to their former state of extravagant happiness. Enough already, he exclaims. She adds that shouting won't make her leave as they circle the room. She is aware that her actions have caused him pain. Ashley queries what she needs to do to demonstrate that she won't ever injure him again as McCall urges her to depart once more. Audra approaches the door. Before she realizes who the other woman is, she gives him a hearty kiss. Tucker claims that she had just departed. Ashley yells, "I'd give that kiss a 3 out of 10, before announcing that she and Tucker will once again be husband and wife because of their once-in-a-lifetime bond. She foolishly destroyed that, but she's determined not to let that happen again. Audra sighs and Tucker shakes his head as she leaves. This was not some covert meeting, he assured her. She can only imagine what she had the courage to say before she arrived, and she wonders why it was happening in a room with a bed. McCall informs her that he has made his feelings known to his ex. He believes it must be some sort of calculated move because she has never insisted on their reunion in this manner. It is not going to work. He tells Audra, caressing her hair, that he nearly lost her once and that he won't allow it to happen again. She believes Ashley's stern demeanor to be mere arrogance. He had more senses than that. She seemed unsure of why she was doing what she was doing. Upon seeing that he has packed for Paris, Audra is pleased and makes a joke about his ex perhaps hiding in his suitcase. Tucker assures her that she won't impede their journey. Audra smiles, eager for them to be apart and together for the first time ever. They share a kiss. After their sexual encounter, he sits and ponders, sensing something is off. Ashley places an order for an old-fashioned at the bar. She believes she suspects, the voice in her thoughts whispers. It won't last very long from now on. Ashley responds to the speaker, then she will be safe forever. Jordan mentions the fire to Victor over the phone. Is it accurate to say that no one was hurt or killed? She's curious as to Claire's actual residence. He refuses to say. Jordan doesn't take his offer to express regret for what he'd done to her sister seriously. He says he's prepared to offer apologies in order to end this awful tale. They quarrel over her allegedly taking Claire. He rolls his eyes and sarcastically remarks that her devotion to her sister is quite heartwarming while expressing his guilt. He wants to see her in the eyes if he is going to make apologies. He can be setting himself up for a snare. Is she prepared to accept that chance? Yes, he is. When Jack gets at the Newman property, Nikki regrets phoning him at such a late hour. Considering that everyone appears to be asleep, he's relieved she chose to do this rather than have a drink. He's relieved that the house is clear of remaining alcohol. That isn't entirely accurate. Nikki approaches the couch and takes out a vodka bottle from under the covers. The seal is intact, and it is filled. She is unsure about where to start. When she brings up murder and fire, he is astounded. As they settle down, she reveals that Seth approached Jordan in a way that was obvious, and that she then shoved him into traffic as a warning. If only she hadn't requested that he lead Jordan on. Jack tells her that she is not at blame. Then she informs him that Jordan set Victoria's house on fire. Fortunately, nobody was harmed. She only needs a drink because she is scared for her family, even though there is security around. He looks at his watch and says they can arrange a meeting if they leave right away. Jack and Nikki visit the athletic club for an AA meeting. She greets the group and gives a brief account of how she was kidnapped and given alcohol by four. That broke her sobriety and forced her to get back in touch with Seth, her long-standing sponsor. She regrets having to inform them, but this Jordanian woman shoved him in front of a car earlier tonight, resulting in his death. She knows she did it even though she has no proof, and she now despises her much more than before. She also feels incredibly bad about enlisting his assistance in order to find this woman. This was the first time he had gone above and above for her, and it cost him his life. She declares, "It will haunt me for the rest of my life and I feel partially responsible." She only wants to go inside a bottle, but that isn't the proper way to pay tribute to him. Her life's work will be to ensure that the monster responsible for his death is held accountable for his actions. To be honest, she wants to see her die in prison, begging for mercy rather than from old age. That's precisely what she will receive, if there is any justice in the world. Jack listens with wide-open lips. Jack returns to the property with Nikki. All that venting had to have felt nice, he's sure. She acknowledges that it did, but Seth will still be dead and Victoria's house will still be gone tomorrow. It certainly did help to tell all those folks how much she detested Jordan. As he listened to her, he felt that she gives him credit for being her hero these days and requests one more favor. She asks him to remove the bottle she gives him after unzipping a pillow. She may be in the thick of things, but you never know when the impulse will return. This is happening when Victor enters. His wife clarifies that she is handing Jack the bottle so he can discard it. He walks out, promising to get rid of it off the ranch. Nikki asks Victor what's really going on when he says he has to call Singapore from the office. He wonders why Jack was there and expresses gratitude that he prevented her from drinking once more. He advises her to get some sleep, but she immediately demands to know his true destination. When Ashley gets home, her brother is taken aback to see how much happier she is. She informs him that she has a new outlook on life, and it does not at all involve Tucker. The next update for today. Will the gate snatch up GC talent? Will new soap cause YNR cast exits? Spoilers for The Young and The Restless indicate that a new soap opera is in the works that might have an impact on events in Genoa City. The Gates will be joining CBS's slate of daytime dramas, therefore we should think about the implications for YNR. This brand new soap opera, which is a collaboration between CBS Studios and the NAACP, will revolve around a wealthy black family who lives in a gated enclave. It's fantastic that after all these years, CBS still believes enough in the soap opera genre to introduce another one. It makes sense to assume they could want to cast some well-known actors in order to increase their chances of success with The Gates. Is it possible that The Gates will pursue some YNR actors who aren't getting enough credit to help build their new ensemble and launch the show? Several fans have already been supporting the casting of some of their idols in new roles on social media. Since Brittany Sarpy doesn't appear on television very much these days as Elena Dawson, is it possible that The Gates will cast her in a different role? It would be intriguing to see what kind of content Sarpy might find there. Another well-known actress who seems like she could steal the show on The Gates is Miss Hale Morgan. The only question left is whether Morgan would accept a full-time role in another soap opera, but if the proper opportunity was made to her, she may. As The Gates takes off at CBS, Sean Dominic is someone else to watch. If The Gates wants Dominic and the money is there, it's easy to see him taking a new role. All of this is important to remember since even former members of YNR, like Victoria Rowell, have been receiving fan buzz regarding their potential as stars for The Gates. Of course, a crossover between The Gates and The Bold and The Beautiful or perhaps The Young and The Restless might also be an option. If so, a few characters from YNR and BNB may show up on The Gates when it premieres. In any case, we'll keep you informed about this new soap opera and any future developments that may impact certain soap opera stars. Thanks for watching this video. Please hit the subscribe button for more updated news.